welcome to Half the Battle. Today, we're taking a look at the GIJoe Swamp Combat Expert.
Meet Muskrat. This figure was released in 1988 with all original body parts. And if you know me, you can probably tell that I'm gonna like this toy. It's got the classic military look that I like, but is distinct enough, thanks to the hat and the sleeveless shirt, to be unique. And, as is usual, there's lots of detailing on the figure, though I have to admit, nothing really stands out. The only real point of criticism I have here is that the hat isn't removable.
His accessories are sort of meh.
He comes with a shotgun, but it doesn't look as nice as the one that Falcon came with, so I'm not impressed. He also has a machete, appropriate for a swamp fighter, but for some reason it's blue. He also comes with something completely useless. It's called a swamp skimmer. It looks like a very small skateboard. I really don't see the point of it. Muskrat got a second figure in 1989 with no original body parts. Yeah, this was a straight repaint, but it was part of my favorite subteam, Night Force.
Though, honestly,
in this case, the different coloring really doesn't add much. Thematically, the character is a good fit for Night Force, but the toy really didn't need to recolor. It's different, but not an improvement. But hey, at least his machete isn't blue anymore.
And those were the only two toys of Muskrat in the original line. There were no others. No, sir. Yes, I am lying. No, I don't want to talk about his third toy.
Well, I did promise myself when I started this show I'd review every single G.I. Joe toy from the original line. So, I guess I have to.
Stupid past me.
This figure was released in 1993 with all original body parts. It sort of looks like the Night Force version, but for some reason, they added horrible Dayglow orange. Yeah, you know how I feel about that, but it really ruins what would have been a pretty cool figure here. Also, the coloring makes it look like he's got his underwear on over his pants. I really hate to see a good figure defaced like that. But you know what? The coloring isn't even the worst part about the figure.
There are some accessories, and if they're not the worst in the entire G.I. Joe line, then they're definitely the least OSHA-compliant ones.
He's got a helmet with a targeting visor, and you may notice it has a strange tab on the side of it. You wanna know what goes on that tab? Try to guess. It's a huge-ass missile launcher! That's right, his helmet supports a freaking missile launcher! This thing would, at the very least, break your neck if you used it, but it more likely would take your head clean off. This is the worst military hardware since the Belgian army ordered those sea rescue helicopters that couldn't handle salt water.
No, really, that happened.
Overall, the first figure is the best. The second one is kind of unnecessary but nice, and the third one is a piece of crap. But at least it's an hilarious piece of crap.
So now we come to the character, starting with the file card.
Muskrat grew up in the swamps of Louisiana hunting animals. He had to deal with poachers, smugglers, and other assorted riffraff, meaning he got very good at using the swamp to his advantage with traps and ambushes. Yeah, you don't really get much of his personality in the cards, only what he's good at. But hey, at least the guy looks the part, right? Hell, the file card lists his secondary military specialty as social services, and then completely ignores that for the rest of the file card. See what I mean?
And there's an additional problem. You see, there's another Joe that's also from Louisiana, and he's kinda got the same background. And he's far, far more famous than Muskrat.
Gung-Ho, the Cajun Marine. Muskrat really seems like a pale imitation next to him. It's also a real pity that the other two later file cards just blandly repeat the first one, with the only difference being that he joined Night Force and Battle Corps. There's really some wasted potential there. Muskrat was created in between the Sunbow and the D cartoon runs, so he didn't feature in either. So, no cartoon section this time.
As far as the comic goes, I'm gonna be brief.
He, shows up. I've never noticed him doing anything that worthy of attention. I'm afraid he's another one of those characters that shows up because he has to, but isn't really used much. Look, the G.I. Joe comic was great overall, but it did suffer from having to include like 200 characters over its run. The folly of a toy tie-in, I suppose.
There's one other weird little tidbit.
Muskrat was also sold in an exclusive 2-pack only available at Target stores, with Voltar as an ultimate enemy set. And that just doesn't make sense. I mean, there's no rivalry between them that I could find. And even if you go by code names, Vultures, who inspired Voltar, are carrion birds and don't go after any particular animal like muskrats. They eat dead things. It's just nonsensical. And that was Muskrat. A cool first figure, but nothing much to say about the character. Bit of a pity, that.
See you next time, everybody!